Hello, everybody. My name is Will. This is WWE 2K17, My Career Mode. This is our superstar, our rookie, who has recently joined the main roster's tag team division. His name is Wildman Will Jack, and he will jack you up. Yes, sir. All right, so we're going to accept and move on. We've just completed our tryout with NXT down in Orlando. It went well. And like I said, we are joining the main roster. Let's see what that entails. Okay, here's our guy. Looks like we have... What was that, Matt Sydal? That looks like... Evan Bourne with mascara. Okay. This section shows your match for the night. Prepare for what's ahead by upgrading your attributes, abilities, and skills. I shall. Looks like we're taking on Los Matadores. Fine, they're not even that anymore. They have a new gimmick. This section gives you all the information you need to know about your superstar. That's not bad. It didn't seem that bad. Okay. Overall rating lets you know how strong at wrestling and performing, that's what I'm trying to say, your superstar is. Popularity shows how many fans you have. The more fans you have, the quicker you will climb up to the rankings to each title. Oh, really? VC is currency that you can buy upgrades with. This includes attributes, skills, abilities, and so much more. Character excitement shows how the WWE Universe perceives you. The WWE Universe can either be hot or cold with you. This changes based on how good or bad your matches are, and promos are, among other things. Just remember to always engage the WWE Universe. I will. I'm going to Instagram. I'm going to Facebook Live. Do all those things that people like. When character excitement is high, you will gain popularity faster. When it is cold, you will begin to lose popularity. The face heel meter shows how good of a face or heel you are. You can make a turn to the other side by doing a face slash heel turn promo while your meter is empty. Well, I think I'd like to stay a heel. Personally. Okay, so we need to... work on our character, yes? And we shall work on our... First of all, let's get our moveset done, Are there things we can do? Are there finishing moves we can add? Can we become exciting in-ring performers? Remember, the Wild Man Will Jack is supposed to be indie-rific. He's gonna do a bunch of... flippy things. That's what we want to do eventually, right? Let's start with standing strikes. Excuse me, close range strike. I want to try to do. Let's do something a little different than usual. I would say let's go with an elbow. I want to preserve, even though he's a heel, that he does not do a close fist. Now, I know in the WWE, a close fist isn't exactly frowned upon, but traditionally, a close fist in wrestling is not allowed. You can't do that in Japan. You go to New Japan, you throw a close fist, that's pretty much the end of the match. Oh, look at all the bruises on this guy. And I agree with that. A close fist in a real fight, it hurts. It leaves big marks. Busted eyes, busted nose, especially when the people hitting you weigh 220, 30, 40 pounds. Okay. Let's see if we can find another just silly, maybe a Mongolian chop. Maybe I might go with the Mongolian chop. Let's go with the Mongolian chop. Why not? Okay, Mongolian chop. Wait. Why is that different? Oh, okay, I see. We're gonna go with the elbow smash. Mongolian chop. Gut punch. No, sir. Maybe a slap. Ooh, I like that one. Throat thrust. About spinning soul kick. Three rich swan. Okay. Woman's kick. And let's finish this thing off right. How about a big European uppercut? Okay. What's a key lock combo? Not bad. Okay. No European uppercut. Shame. Ooh. Oh, yeah. That's the ticket. We can't do that. That's fine. Okay. Close range strikes with the elbow. That's what we want. Strike combo. Elbow smash. Head punch. Elbow smash. Head punch. Well, instead of a head punch, we do... How about we do ourselves a little... How about a kick to the gut? Kick to the gut's fine. Elbow smash. Kick to the gut. Strong strikes. Alright, so we want something a little bit more impressive. Okay, this is for... what is almost a grappling situation? Can we do... Again, we want to do... Stuff that's pretty standard... Indie superstar. Now, not like... When I say indie, I don't mean... Like the guys off at your local promotions who are just learning. You know, bless their souls. I mean the Will Ospreys of the world, the Ricochets, the guys at the upper echelon of performing all over the world in these independent circuits. Ah, exciting moments are moves that will put the WWE universe in awe. Oh, okay, so... If we add a people's punch, that's considered an exciting moment. Is there any more like that? Because again, I want to do no close fist. Unless, you know, it's dirty. It's a dirty move. Oh, looks like that's it. Okay. Is there a super kick? We can't do a super kick in this situation. And the knee lift would be pretty cool. Okay, let's snapmare soccer ball kick. I think I like that. Ooh, Jigo Katuki. I don't know how to say that, and that's fine, that's fine. No super kicks, that's fine. What's a chick kick? What is that? Oh, that's just a big old round kick. Big old roundhouse to the head. Oh, I like this. Oh yeah, basement dropkick. We're going with that one. That's what I'm trying to say. Can we do a Pele kick? We can. Beautiful. Awesome. Okay, and again, no super kick. And that's cool. Let's go with maybe some more enziguris. It's an enzu lariat. Okay. Oh, awesome. Maybe a flying heel kick would be right in this situation. I just want to do such... See, look. When you throw a headbutt, you don't want to hit them in the same spot. You want to hit them where it's soft. In the nose. In the mouth, even. Maybe in the ear. In the around the eyes. But you want to avoid the forehead. That is a terrible place to headbutt somebody. Now, I know the reason why you do that in professional wrestling, but it's something I just cannot abide. I cannot abide a headbutt. I will not do a headbutt. Maybe a good, long, or big chop. Ooh, ooh. Wow, yes. That's our move. Okay. Rear clothesline. That might be the one we go with. European uppercut. Front jump kick. Drop kick. I always like that. then we'll go with a regular drop kick as well. Running strike. Super kick, of course. Is there any question? Super kick party. Okay. That's going to be one of our runs. The other one can be... maybe. Maybe a flippy thing. Ooh, single leg high knee. That's pretty cool. Okay. Let's do... ooh, I love this. Let's do this. Okay, we're gonna do the jumping knee strike. Alright, let's go ahead and... we're gonna do drop kicks here, I think. Beautiful. Okay, kick reversal. How about leg caught windmill kick? Leg caught spine buster? No, dragon screw. We'll do dragon screw. No! Exploder? German. German with a trapped leg. Yep, that's it. Submission one. Can we do lion tamer? Chris Jericho's elevated version of his Walls of Jericho, which is one of my favorite moves, because without it, it's just a Boston Crab, and I'm not into that. Ooh. We can do the figure eight. No, I think we're going to do the Muda Lock. That's what we'll do. Okay. Yep, Muda Lock. Also known as the Last Chancery and the Emma Lock. But this time we're going to do the Muda Lock. Okay, shove back reversal. Enziguri reversal. Mule kick. Oh yeah, we're doing mule kick. Flippy flip. Okay, we got all our standing strikes. Let's get our finisher in line, huh? In-ring finisher. No, I hate the Yokosuka Cutter. And my guy's not a big guy, so it doesn't make sense. Can we get a Stone Cold Stunner? Mm-hmm. Can we get a Stunner? Boombaye. Boombaye. Mm-hmm, that was it. Because one of the things I noticed about Nakamura when he made the jump from New Japan to WWE... his knee, well, they call it the Kinshasa now, which is actually the city in which Ali fought. Was it Foreman? I think it was Foreman. In the Rumble in the Jungle. They changed the name of it, but they also changed the way he does it. It doesn't quite look as powerful. See, that is the old Boomaye knee. That's what he used to call it. And you can see because of the way that the person striking has some weight behind the knee, which is what a good strong strike would be, especially when you throw your whole body into it like he does. I really want to do that. maybe we'll remember that for something. Springboard stunner. No, I just want to do a regular stunner, but it doesn't look like we can do that. Let's do a standing in front. It does look like we don't have a whole lot of moves available at this moment. I wonder, are we going to have to buy some? Because if we have to buy some, I don't particularly like that. I like the Code Breaker. I might go with the Code Breaker for now, just until we can figure out what else we can do. Face plant. I'm gonna plant your face. No. Okay. Falcon Arrow, that's kind of a pretty good standard. Flying heel kick. No. We could just do a super kick. But we're going to do so many. No jackhammer. No last ride. Okay. Oh, that's AJ Styles' little flurry of punches and kicks. A rock bottom. No, that's going to be one of our signature moves. Okay. Well, it looks like we have a whole lot of moves missing. That ain't fun. That ain't fun at all. Alright, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to figure out how we can buy more moves. Can we buy more moves? Yes, we can. Purchase moveset. Okay. This year, you'll be able to purchase moves in packs. These packs will be separated by type and move grade. The higher the grade, the more expensive the pack. Move grade detects how exciting a move is to the WWE universe. The higher the move grade, the more exciting your matches will be. This will get you over with the WWE universe and give your crowd excitement bonuses. Oh, really? So, I think we should buy a special... Oh, that's expensive. Can we look at what it is? Oh, okay, there it is. That's how we can look. Attitude adjustment. RKO off the ladder. Rock bottom off the ladder. Curb stomp. I would love to do a curb stomp. Go to sleep in a penalty kick. That seems... I mean, I like it. Just seems a little much. Punt kick. Maybe the punt kick. Punt kick's pretty dope. Don't like the Sister Abigail. Not a fan. Okay. Ooh, McMahon stunner. It's all awkward. So this is where... Oh, this is what we want to buy. All these moves. Oh, God. Man, okay. Okay. Well, it's expensive, huh? All right. Well, what about this? The B. Not as much fun, really. Maybe a leaping tombstone pile driver would be kind of cool. Oh, beautiful. Ooh, a shining wizard. Okay. Canadian destroyer? Maybe. Okay. That's still a lot of money. We might just have to be content in what we have. What are standard actions? What are those exactly? Female in and out. Really? That's what we get. Okay. Okay. So I think we're going to hold out on that for now. Unfortunately. So when we do our special moves, let's go ahead and get our finisher here. Why not? Let's not be wasting too much time with this. I would say let's do a strong style knee. Can we do that? We'll do the Bumae knee. Why not? It's one of my favorite moves. Anyway, just doesn't have that flair. Is it, oh, no, it's in the corner, isn't it? We're in the corner. Opponent's not. Yeah. Okay. Well, that's fine. We can pull this one off. Okay. Strong style knee finisher. Oh, I can't have more than one finisher. Okay, ringside finisher. Since we can't do a Bumae knee out in the ring, outside of the ring here, apparently. Let's see what we can do. Can we do? Let's do a big bomb. Torture rack bomb. No, thank you. Schoolboy power bomb. Nah. Maybe electric chair power bomb would be almost like an old the one wing angel. I think that's the best you can do as far as getting to the one winged angel, which is of course Kenny Omega's finishing move, which is such a cool. That would be the move I would do in this game. It's just a fun setup. It's a fun... First of all, it's a Final Fantasy VII thing, which is awesome. Let's do a Styles Clash here. Why not? Just really hurt somebody with it. Okay. Signatures. Let's do something... I actually like doing the Alabama Slam. Because it looks so dangerous, doesn't it? Let's do something... How about for a signature, we do somebody's actual finishing move. Maybe an attitude adjustment. Maybe the F5. Maybe the code breaker, if we can... I think, actually, let's see if we can do the code breaker for it. Let's go all the way back up here. I like the code breaker, and it kind of goes into the knee thing anyway, so... We do a big knee for our finish now, with the code breaker for the signature. Let's do one from behind as well. What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? Okay. You don't have exciting moves. It's gonna be expensive, I think, getting exciting moves. But I think we need to really work on our attributes. Ooh. Yeah, let's go with the electric chair power bomb. Okay. Signatures on the outside. Let's see. Maybe. If we can get... All of these are good things to pick, I think. I want to do a slam or a power bomb or a suplex on the outside. Shooting star press, maybe? No, we'll do that inside. That'll just be something we throw away on the inside. Maybe a uranagi. Just kind of like a rock bottom, you see? Well, it is a rock bottom. Ooh. Yeah, okay. We're gonna do that. The Meteora, which is, I think you see Sasha Banks do it more than anything. I think that's like half of her offense, which is cool. She's smaller. It works for her. But there, what that is knees, like encompassing somebody's head, and then you fall back with it. Or your opponent falls back with it. And that's pretty... What? Whoa. Oh, they counted off. Look at that. That is creepy when you're in an empty arena. The Argentine backbreaker. That would be the rack attack. No, it always looks stupid to me. Yeah, I think we're going to do... Let's do the attitude adjustment. There we go. Alright. Oh my god. Do we have any oh my god moves? We can't do any of them yet. And that's cool, man. Alright. Let's go back to... We had our strikes, I think. Let's do our standing grapples. I think a European uppercut or a knee. Yeah, we'll do the first knee strike. Okay. So this is... What is this? Oh, this is just another grapple here. Okay. We can do Bailey's finisher. We might be able to do that. Do we have any super kicks? Super kick. No super kick. Ooh, lame. Let's do the Bailey to belly. Why not? Yeah, now you can't use it, Bailey. My move. That's not bad. But let's do something a little funky, huh? No brain busters. Dragon screw. No, that's a little too... Can we spit mist? We do poison mist. Okay. Ooh, Hammerlock Northern Lights. I don't know if I really want my guy to be a suplex guy, though. Especially when there's so many Hurricane Ranas that we can do. Not the biggest fan of Hurricane Ranas. I like an inverted Hurricane Rana, or reverse Hurricane Rana. For the top, that's always just scary to see. Shinbreaker Dragon Screw? Maybe. Alright, let's go with... Ooh, Ankle Pick Knee Crusher. That's not as cool looking as I thought it would be, boy. What's a bankrupt? Don't like that. What is that? Ted DiBiase Jr.'s thing? Didn't he do that, or am I imagining that? Either way, don't care for it. Okay, so here's what I think we're going to do. No drop toe holds, unless it's on a chair. Let's get a big... where is it? What was I thinking? Let's get a Hurricane Rod in there. That's fine. I can do a Hurricane Rod. Let's make it big like that, too. Okay. Back body drop. That ain't flippy enough for me, son. Mm-mm. So, let's get a Jawbreaker. Yeah, we can do that. It's kind of like a Stone Cold Stunner. Ooh, what's a Scoop Slam and Punch? Oh, that's kind of cool, man. That's kind of cool. Let's see. One of the neck breakers. There's no DDTs here. Okay. That's cool. Let's just do a swinging neck breaker. Why not? Okay, limb target. So when we target the head, what do? Maybe a big old DDT, like so. Maybe, just maybe, we do ourselves. Let's see, what should we do? Super kick, we have a super kick. We do not have a super kick. We cannot do one yet. What are they trying to do to me? Oh, that's mean. I think that's our thing. Okay. Alright. So this is for the arm. Powerbomb shoulder breaker. Really? That's interesting. Ooh, that's mean. That's mean, boy. Okay. Maybe Fujiwara? About this. There we go. We'll do that. Okay. Next move. This is also for... Looks like the arm. I think I always like the jumping arm breaker. Okay, for the leg. A shin breaker. How about just a leg kick? Leg sweep knee crusher. Ooh, that's mean. Yeah, we're gonna do that. I don't really want to do too many submissions. Medium grapple, front. Stalling suplex. Now, no stalling suplex today, sir. What I think we should do is a rock bottom. Just a throwaway rock bottom move. Alright, military press slam. Our guy is a smaller guy. He's big in real life. But in the world of wrestling, especially the WWE, he's like 208. That's not huge. No gorilla press slams. We're not doing that. Let's see. Go home driver. What is that? I hate that. Fisherman driver is kind of cool. Like a perfect plex into a Falcon Arrow or a Mikanochu driver. I don't know why I said that weird. Don't like the deep six. Not a fan. Maybe a DDT. Just regular old DDT would work. Yeah, okay. Let's, you know what? We always go from the bottom up. Let's go down this way, see what we're missing. Butterfly suplex? It's kind of cool. Maybe an eye rake? Excuse me, it's really late. Ugh. They record very late at night. A loud home during the day. Got a loud baby. Plus, I watch my child. Spend time with her. That's always important to do. You understand. Let's see. Snap DDT could be cool, but we're already doing a DDT. Ooh, but I like that one. Let's go with that one, and we'll replace this DDT with maybe a sit-out jawbreaker. That's kind of cool. That's kind of a cool thing to do. Okay. And then our last, again, we have no super kick. Maybe a spine buster would be all right. Jumping arm breaker? No. Let's go with the jackhammer. Again, we were talking about iconic finishing moves. There, jackhammer. Goldberg. That's who did that. What else can we do? Can we do one of these spinny things? Absolutely we can. Okay, these are all back grapples. We can do a pump handle uranage. Maybe a Frankensteiner. Yeah, we're gonna do a Frankensteiner. A backstabber, that could work. I always like the backstabber. Lumbar check, whatever you want to call it. Actually, I really like lumbar check as a name. Who calls it that? It's Cedric Alexander, I think, calls it that. Okay. Cedric Alexander, of course, from ROH, Ring of Honor. He was part of the Cruiserweight Classic, and he's currently part of the WWE Cruiserweight Division on Monday Night Raw. And I think he's got a program working at NXT as well. Good for him. Haven't been watching NXT lately. Though I need to. I need to get caught up. Alright, let's do a lifted inverted DDT. Wait, what is this? Show me this. Oh, that's mean. Yeah, we'll go with that, because that's mean. Alright, strong grapples from the front. This is where things are going to get fun, because now we can get a no super kick, really? Alright, Styles Clash. Again, iconic finishing move. Just throwing it out. Like it ain't no thing. That's what we do. Okay. Maybe Razor's Edge. Is it? Oh, he sits with it there. I don't want to sit with it. So we need to remember Crucifix Bomb. Ooh, perfect plex. What's a pop-up Styles? Oh, awesome. Yeah, maybe we go with Kurt Hennig's fisherman suplex there. The last ride. That might be something we go with. Let's see. Do we have a? We can just do an F5 as well. Do we have a crucifix bomb? No crucifix bomb. That's lame. So, let's go with the last ride. Yep. Like I said, iconic finishing moves. Wish we could sit it out, like, who sits it out? Oh, Kota Ibushi does. Love Kota Ibushi. Go back a couple of Wrestle Kingdoms ago. God, was it? I think it was Wrestle Kingdom 9? Nakamura versus Kota Ibushi at the Tokyo Dome. One of my favorite matches. Definitely, I think, might be my favorite match of the last 5 years. So check that out if you like wrestling. You can usually find it on Vimeo or Daily Motion. There's a few English language commentaries if you like that. If you need that, which I prefer it if I can get it, but it's not the biggest deal. But it's such a great, great match. Nakamura also had a great one against AJ earlier this year, before they both came to the WWE and NXT, respectively. That was also at Wrestle Kingdom, also at the Tokyo Dome. Wrestle Kingdom, you can't really say it's New Japan's WrestleMania. It is the closest equivalent. Of course, WWE is a much bigger company, so the spectacle of their biggest show is so grander on scale. But the quality of wrestling in the Wrestle Kingdom is unmatched, in my opinion. So if you love good wrestling and you want to see New Japan at its fanciest, I would say check out Wrestle Kingdom every year. It's excellent. Usually in Japan, or in January. It's always in January. I'm not sure. Is it on the 4th? I think it's like a weird date for us. Like the 4th of every January. It's early January. That's all, like, you know. And you can find it usually on Daily Motion or Vimeo. Or New Japan World, if you want to pay for it. Again, attitude adjustment might be the thing we go with. All right, so that's our last of the strong front grapples. Okay, again, iconic finishing moves for all. Let's go with... Do we have anything back here that is an iconic finishing move or flippy for almost no reason? Almost no reason. Okay. Okay, my friend. What is the electric chair drop roaring elbow? I put you down? Hit you? I don't like that. I don't like that. That looks like you messed up your spot and just try to cover it. Okay. So I say maybe the torture rack bomb? Do we have the burning hammer? No burning hammer. Ugh. Okay. That's fine. So let's go with the pump handle Uranagi. And we'll also go with... We've already done a backstabber. I think we threw that away earlier. We've done the Frankensteiner. Maybe go with the German with a bridge. I think it's this one. How about this one? What's the difference? We just hold it. Yeah, let's go with this one. No, we'll go with the suplex. The first one with the bridge afterwards. Okay, back. Suplex. No, I don't think so. I don't think we're going to do that. Let's go with... Do we lift it? Let's do the lift inverted DDT. And for our final one, of course, we could do a dragon suplex. It's mean looking. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay, except running grapple. That's a big ol' arm drag. I do like that. Hurricane Rana? Maybe. We might go with the Meteora, though. Tilt-A-Whirl DDT. Tilt-A-Whirl Small Package. Okay. Let's go with the Meteora. And for our second one, let's go with... I'm thinking the Hurricane Rana, though. I'm not a big Hurricane Rana fan, but... This guy seems like he throws a lot of Hurricane Ranas. Doesn't he? He does. Except... running rear grapples. Okay. I don't like these running grapples that make you stop. I want to keep the momentum going. Front neck chancery. So we're gonna find something that keeps the momentum going, I think. Maybe, do we have a face crusher or a bulldog? Any bulldogs? No bulldogs, really? No bulldogs. One-handed bulldog, there we go. And what's the last one we'll do? It might end up being this Hurricane Rana, and then we'll go back to what I think is our medium grapples rear and change this one to something like maybe a tiger suplex. Ooh, mean. Did we take the dragon suplex before? I don't recall. Let's go with the tiger suplex. I've always liked the tiger suplex. Okay. So running grapples rear. We've got that, and we're good with our grapples. So now we can do our ground. It's going to be a long episode, I think. Hammerlock armbreaker. Upper. Maybe a sit-out powerbomb, running neck twist. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're going to do that. Gloating knee press. Ooh, look at me. I don't think I've ever liked this. Nope, never liked that. Rolling monkey flip. We might go with that. I like that. Okay. And for down here, I say we go with not a camel clutch. Maybe a stump puller? Yeah, we'll go with the stump puller. Okay. Strong strike. Let's see. Let's go with... Let's see. What can we do? Cartwheel elbow drop. Yes, sir. Don't mind if I do. Oh, yes. Yes. Now, we gotta go shooting star. Everybody does a shooting star press, right? You have to do a shooting star press. Okay, what else can we do? Maybe a low blow. Leg stomp, maybe. Knee to a groin. Boing. Okay, let's go with the low blow. Just punch him right in the nuts. Okay, moving on. Strong strikes. Face down. Strong strikes face down. That's what I wanted to say. Shining Wizard. This is one of my favorite moves. That's not the Shining Wizard I want to do. Low drop kick. Low drop kick. That's what we'll do. Okay. Elbow drop with push-ups. That sounds like something I really want to do. Put your hand on his ass and just do some push-ups. Okay. Let me just adjust my seat real fast. There we go. Knee to the groin. A belly stomp. Nah. We'll do a low blow again. And we've already done a low blow. Oh yeah, okay, that's what we'll do. This is a mean thing to do. Okay. When they are kneeling, we'll do a sidekick. No. Chop. We'll do a chop. Big boot. Strong kick. We'll do a strong kick. Running strike. Now, that is going to be the big boot. That is mean looking. Drop kick, though. That could be cool. No, we'll do the big boot. We'll do the big boot. Okay. Ooh, a Hurricane Rana spike DDT. Ooh. Ooh. Kneeling? No. Yeah, we're going to do the spike DDT Hurricane Rana there. Okay. Running rear. Oh, it's not running. Grapple rear on a kneeling opponent. Maybe a backbreaker. Yeah, we'll do a backbreaker. Okay. We're good there. A seated opponent. What is the flippiest? Repeated headbutts? Well, that's just weird looking. Yeah, we're... You know what? I like the setup to that. I think that's the one we're going to go with. Okay. Seated elbow barrage. No, we're going to do the dropkick. I think the dropkick's cool. Running strike. Yeah, we might go with the knee strike. European uppercut. Yeah, let's do the knee strike. Okay. Alright. Seated grapple. The foot DDT, that's just weird to me. That's just a weird thing to do. Yeah, we'll go with the leg breaker. And I think the head crank, that's pretty old school. We'll go with that. Limb target. Running neck twist. Oh, really? So we're doing the face? Is that what we're doing? Head? What's a colossal clutch? Oh, grabbing him by the face. Okay. Spinning leg drop. I think this is our baby right here. What do you think? What about this? Nah, we'll do the running neck twist here. Alright, for the arm. Yeah, we'll do the spinning arm breaker. And for the leg, what is the stretch muffler? What is the Patriot lock? Oh, it's just an ankle lock. Okay, you know what? Patriot lock, ankle lock, iconic finishing move of Kurt Angle, though I usually associate it with Ken Shamrock. That's cool. Flipping senton. That's got to be it, right? That's the one we go with when we do a custom running attack. Big leg drop, sure. And let's do a big elbow drop as well. Okay, we're good there on the ground opponent. Stunned against the ropes. What can we do? Can we do a super kick? Finally. We can't do a super kick. Really? Okay. Well, you're really, really screwing me here, son. Okay. Let's see, what can we do? What can we do that's either silly or really mean? Alright, let's go. You know what? Let's just go with the high kick. Yeah, we'll do a high left. Trapped bliss. Blitz. Ooh. Ooh, that's mean. Rope assisted stomp. Don't like that. Don't care for that. Ooh, is this a 619? Well, you know we're doing it. Wait, no, it's not. That's not a 619, is it? That's not a 619. Well, it's kind of cool looking, though. What about this? Is this what Alexa Bliss does in the corner here? Or on the ropes? You know what? We're going to go for it. Seeing a grown man do that, different than a tiny woman. We're going to go with the drop kick there in that situation. Grapple. A springboard stunner. Yeah, I think we can do that. Let's do that. And plus, in a video game, you never botch it. Suicide dive. Maybe Suicide Senton would work. Let's see, what does that look like? Come on, get up. Whoa! Let's go with just a regular old suicide dive. On the head. Okay. Stunned against the middle rope. A knee drop. No. Body avalanche. I think that's the one we should go with. Yeah, we'll go with the body avalanche. Okay. Hold. For our working hold, let's go with the old-fashioned chin lock. And for our... what is this? Front face lock? Okay. Let's see. We can go with the Cobra Clutch. We could. Iconic finishing move, sure. Could go with the Bank Statement. No. Let's go with the Cobra Clutch. Of course, iconic finishing move of one Sergeant Slaughter. Okay. So, what is this? The... where are we? Holds on the ground. Upper submission. Let's go with the Shoulder Claw. Because, come on. I've always... You don't see this as much, but you used to see it a lot with big monster heels in the 80s and 90s. They would just grab your shoulder. I'm sure there's a pressure point there, but it's like, come on, man. Just come on, man. Okay, the Camel Clutch. Maybe. Sheiky Baby. That's a iconic finishing move. Sure. You know what? There's just something... we'll go with the Camel Clutch. Okay. And for the last one, we've done a Moodle Lock already. Do we want to do a Moodle Lock again? I think so. I think we go with the Moodle Lock again. Okay. Okay, so seated, working hold... be a headlock. Yeah. Okay. We are good there. Irish whip attacks. Now, there's got to be a super kick in here. Yes, sir, there is. Take it. Take it to the face. Okay. So this is the grapple version of it. We want to do something. What's the Bailey press? Oh. It's a Luthez press. When she does like a face slam. Japanese arm drag. Pop-up styles clash. I think we go with the tilt-a-whirl. What do you think? Think that's okay? I think so. And for the second one, maybe an overhead belly-to-belly. Maybe a belly-to-belly. Yeah, let's go with the belly-to-belly. Just like that. Okay. Rebound action. Oh, it's gonna be leapfrogs all day. We got drop-downs, we got our leapfrogs, we're cool. Okay, so our pullbacks. Maybe a leg lariat, maybe a knee strike. Yes, jumping knee. And for our grapple version, Hurricane Rana, I think. I think that's the one we go with. Okay. We good. Okay. So, Slingshot Tornado DDT. Okay, we'll go with that. Opponent on the ringside. Well... we'll go with the drop axe, or the pump handle. Not pump handle, the axe handle. Running attack. Again, it's gotta be a Hurricane Rana. Right? I mean, I think I would like to do like a senton, but a Hurricane Rana might work. Nope, ass to the face. Go with the hip attack. There is a match I saw recently. I think it was Kenny Omega teaming up with we in the U.S. call her Asuka. Of course, in Japan, she was known as Kana. And they were taking on Masato Tanaka, who fans of ECW in the late 90s, early 2000s would remember as just being a guy that took way too many chair shots to the head. He had to wrestle Mike Awesome a lot, and that meant he had to get hurt a whole lot. Resilient, though, tenacious, he managed to pull it off. Okay, you know what? That's a stunner. We'll go with the stunner. But it's a crazy match where I believe at one point Kenny Omega just pulled down his pants and there's just his ass is hanging out. Asuka / Kana does a whole lot of those running hip attacks, and a lot of her attacks are actually ass based. So they really play up that there's quite a bit of ass offense in this match. See, I found it on Vimeo or Daily Motion. You want to check it out. I forgot what it's called, but if you just type in the participants there, Tanaka, Kenny Omega, Kana, you'll find it. I forgot who the other woman on Tanaka's team was. I'm not totally familiar with Japanese women's wrestling. It's just kind of hard to get, but from what I remember, she's supposed to be a big deal. Let's see. We'll go with the shoulder block here. Okay. I got a little distracted there. We'll go with the apron low blow because we are bad guys. We are heels. Thinking right here, a leg drop would be real mean. So we'll go with a leg drop when the opponent is under the rope. Big boot, maybe? Oh, yes. Big boot. Okay. Corner attacks. Do we have anything big? Kicks? Yeah, we'll go with that kick. Big knife edge chop as well. Running attack. Now, this could be fun. Imagine there's a whole lot of them. Let's do... Is there a running front drop kick? Nope. Ooh! It's a running knee strike. Nope. Okay. I think what we're going to do is the double knee strike because it's so mean looking. For our strong strikes, I think we should go with... No, I don't like that. Let's go with... Let's see... Ooh, wait. Can we just do like corner punches with people counting? Go real old school. Doesn't look like we can. Well, that's fine, I suppose. It's a face slam into boot. No, we ain't doing that. Where is that? Let's see. It was. It ended with a drop kick. Where is that? Did we lose it? Did we lose it forever? We may have. We may have. Alright, well... We could go with that. Let's go with that. Okay. Next on the agenda... Let's see... Corner frying pan chop. No, thank you. let's go with the Meteora here. I'm not a huge fan of it, but we can go with it. Fits the character, I suppose. Diving down dropkick. Oh, really? You know what I want to do? Iconic finishing move number, 20 that we've done. Yokozuna's Banzai Drop. Huh? Just use the weight of our mass. Of course, it's a little different. Yokozuna weighed 500, 600, 700 pounds. Our guy is 200. So it's not quite the same. This might work. Ooh. What's a moonsault attack? I imagine it's a moonsault. That's a pretty cool moonsault. We might go with that. Let's see. Is there anything else that's kind of... We could go with the Buckle Bomb. But to me, Buckle Bomb's not as impressive. It's a kind of a scary move because the person taking it can't see exactly when the point of impact's going to be. Which has led to a few people getting hurt. I think I like the idea of the triangle dropkick, so we're going to go with that one. Unless the moonsault attack has... Nope, triangle dropkick. Okay. Okay, except... Stunned Rear. Heard that one before. Let's just go with that. Why not? That's all the same. Front dropkick right here. And for this one, maybe O'Connor roll into a German. That's kind of cool. Where you hold on to it and then you flip them over just like that. I think the Tornado DDT is more of our style, though. And what's a rebound suplex? Oh, that's pretty cool. What's the final cut? Okay, no, we're going to go with the O'Connor roll into the German. Okay, top rope front. Maybe a knee attack? Yeah, we'll go with the knee attack. Okay. Drop kick? How about a corner enziguri? I always like that. Yeah, corner enziguri. All right, from the top. Avalanche, Bailey to Bailey. Oh, this isn't from... Yeah, it is from the top. Okay. How about a Falcon Arrow? Big Falcon Arrow. I think that's cool. Doing a Falcon Arrow. Oh! It's that one. Where you hold on to it. So, are they going to show me the difference between the Hurricane Rana and the Frankensteiner? I mean, they're the same moves. Okay. That's fine. Avalanche Rolling Hills. Is this going to be awesome? You know, let's go with the Superplex Falcon Arrow. Alright. Ooh, iconic finishing move. But I think we have to go with the Hurricane Rana, right? We have to. Okay, run and grapple. Deadly drive, that's fine. Okay, top rope, seated rear. Spider suplex. Oh, yes. What's a tornado bomb? No, spider suplex, and then for the other one, we will do an avalanche German. Okay, seated. Corner stomps. Oh yeah, we're gonna do the turnbuckle dropkick. And I think the knee strike is most appropriate. But that's so mean looking. Now we'll do the dropkick. Okay, and the grapple will be... Slingshot, guillotine leg drop. Okay, yeah, we can do that. Tree of Woe position. Kick to the gut's fine. Drop kick. We want to do a low drop kick here, don't we? Yeah, we do. Yeah, we'll do a low drop kick. And for a stomp. Oh, yes. Yeah, we'll do that stomp. Okay, diving. Oh, we don't have any top rope moves. Okay, we'll just do a blockbuster for that one, and then on the stage we will do we'll do the Hurricane Run on the stage. Unless there's a senton. There's not. Okay. So obviously we're gonna have to go back and change a lot of these things further down the line to get that exciting. We can do a Phoenix Splash off the top? Yes, please. Yeah, hell yeah, we're doing that. Yeah, so we don't have access to top rope moves yet, but we will. We will. Don't worry. From the top here, let's do just a big elbow, right? Wow, look at that. It's just terrible. There we go. There's Macho's. Macho Man's. Beautiful. Okay. Tag team. We don't have a tag. Oh, we are in a tag team now, so we might run into a situation where we need to use it. How about, we need to have something fancy, huh? Yeah, we'll go with that. No Meltzer drivers? Hmm? No 3D? Really? Really? Tag punch? Maybe a tag punch would be alright. Maybe a double super kick would be cool. Yeah, there we go. There's a super kick. Somebody did a super kick at least. Okay. And maybe a combination in Zaguri. No, not that. I want something where we're both involved, right? Let's just do the Russian leg sweep. Okay. Corner. Assisted stump puller. That could be cool. Stump puller is kind of like an inverted Boston crab. That time, it's more of an impact move. 3D, absolutely. We're doing the 3D. Whoop! How can you not do it? You have to do it, right? Grand Amplitude's not bad, right? What is that exactly? I forget. It's kind of a cool move, but how about Midnight Hour? Do they have Midnight Hour? No, Midnight Hour? Oh, yes, we're doing this. Yeah. Okay. Hurricane Rana into a power bomb. Absolutely. We have to do that. Drop kick and complete shot. What is that? Ooh. Foot stomp backbreaker. This is cool. This is cool right here. This is mean. Yep. That's on the list. All right. I'm not a big fan of the Shatter Machine. Like, if they just brought it up to the head, I would care a whole lot more. To where it's a code breaker instead of like a reverse backstabber. I mean, I'm sure it hurts. It looks a little weird to me. I don't know. Maybe I haven't seen it. I mean, I've seen it enough. Doomsday Device. That's what we'll do. Do the old Road Warriors. Yep. Absolutely. Iconic finishing moves. weight detection. We could do a flatliner. Sure. Sure we can, boss. But we could also do something a little bit flippy. Like a crucifix. Which is also a pin. Alright. So for this, let's do a kick of some type. You know what? I said I didn't like it, but there's something about this that's ridiculous. So maybe we'll do that. Maybe. Let me think. I'm just gonna go through this and think. Yeah, we'll do the headbutting rampage. Sure. What else can we do here? How about, let's do a double knee arm breaker. Sure. And for the leg. Leg pick a knee drop. Yeah, we'll do that. Cool. Medium grapple. How about we do, what's a G grip? Oh, just a choke to the floor. Okay. Float over neck breaker. No, I don't think so. Don't think so. How about the code breaker? Yeah, we'll go with the code breaker. And we'll do the backstabber. Go along with the old code breaker. Front ways, back ways, both ways work. Weight detection into a styles clash. Alright. what's a French kiss? Really? We gonna kiss? Nope. Just a DDT. No kissing there. Alright, let's go with the styles clash there. Sure. And what is the other side of it? We will do ourselves a Frankensteiner. Corner grapple. Wrist lock Hurricane Rana. Disappointed by the lack of super kicks. What's a glitter blizzard? Oh, no. Don't want to do that. Would be cool to get like a Canadian destroyer. Let's go with the tornado DDT. And from the rear. You know what? No. We'll go with the rope DDT. Is this one? No, that's not it. Where is it? What do they even call it? Gotta find it. Hurricane Rana, Hurricane Rana, Hurricane Rana. Wrist lock Hurricane Rana. Okay. For this one, maybe we go this? This is kind of cool looking, right? Yeah, okay, we'll go with this one. All right. So from up here, let's just go with the Frankensteiner. And in the back, about just the neck breaker. Okay. The decapitator. Well, that's mean. Wrecking ball dropkick. Oh, yes. Yes. Maybe. I mean, it's so cool looking. Okay. We might end up doing a suicide dive. Yeah, let's do a suicide dive. I think we did two before. Let's do three. How's that look? How's she look, huh? How's she look? And we're doing that for the exciting moments grade. Okay. Cool. Apron grapple. Slingshot tornado DDT would be cool from here, right? Not a spike DDT. Elbow backstabber combo. That could work. Maybe a drop kick, just knock him out to the outside. Sunset flip powerbomb, that's what we'll do. Okay, good, yeah. There we go, just like that. Boom, boom, boom. Cool. Running grapples. We have a DDT. Pop-up Meteora? Maybe. Let's go ahead and just do the moves we're already doing. That's why we're doing them. because we are a bit on the smaller scale. Though, the weights in WWE are changing. There are a lot more smaller guys now. Because there is such an influx of indie talent in the WWE now. Guys that weren't necessarily big football players that blew out their knees and tried out wrestling at the age of 30. Though there's plenty of those guys. A lot of these guys are on the roster now are guys that started training when they were teenagers. Done the indie circuit for 10, 15, 18 years, some of them. Wrestled in other promotions and now they're here. Let's go with a Pele kick. I always like a Pele kick. Okay. Pull back Hurricanrana, of course. Ladder grapple. Yeah, we'll do the smash. Okay. Special moves. Can we do a ladder special move? Can we do anything? We'll do the chop. We'll do the karate chop to the head. I like the ladder smash, so we'll keep that. No finishers. We can't do one. And that's cool. Table. All right. World's Strongest Slam through the table. Maybe an F5. Maybe an F5. I love the pop-up powerbomb. But I'm thinking maybe rock bottom. Again, iconic finishing move. Yeah, let's go with the rock bottom. Or the uranage, if you want to be technical about what it's actually called. Backdrop. Buckle bomb. We'll do the buckle bomb, I think. Yeah, we'll do the buckle bomb. Do Samoan drop off the top. Scoop slam. Let's go with... Oh, this is going outside. You know what? I doubt this is going to happen, so we'll do a military press drop outside onto the table. Who knows? Maybe we can pull it off. Goodbye, there, guy. Ooh, we can do your Nagi off the apron here. Yes. Okay, finisher. Finisher. We'll go with the F5 here. And we will go with... what can we do? Alabama Slam. That's just mean looking through there. So we'll do that too. We're very mean guys. We have to go with the last ride up here. Right? Right? Well, personally, this should be the finisher of the cell. Power bombing somebody off the side of the cell, straight onto the floor. Look at that. No tables down there. That's death. You should be arrested. Okay. Sticking Uranage onto the barricade is probably the thing that hurts the most out of all of these things here. So we will go with that. Yeah, we'll do the big boot too. Okay, I think we're almost done here. We've just got a few of our taunts to do. And let's see. Who does a taunt I really like? Is there a muscle? Let's do... Yep, that's the one. Absolutely. All right. See, how about one of the vaudevillains? Simon Gotch. Can we do Simon Gotch's? I guess we can't. No Simon Gotch. And that's fine. That's fine, I guess. We do like a Adam Cole, baby. Well, that's there we go. That one. Alright. We'll do Gold Dust. Right there. That's cool. Let's do Asuka's. little ass slap. Sure. Victory, no. Smarts, yep. Point at the old noggin there. And one more. Do Sasha Banks. Yeah, we'll do Sasha Banks. Why not? I'd rather do her little shoulder thingy that she does. Head cool, I'm the boss look. But that's fine. We can do this one. Alright, let's do the... What's the D-Von? Is that the WhatsApp? Nope. This is Holy Trinity there. Shoulder shrug. I like that. We'll just, like, I don't know. What are we doing here? We'll do that. And we'll do a scream at the crowd. Del Rio. No, we won't do a Del Rio. What's the straight edge? Oh, yeah. Okay. None of that. Let's just do... Yeah, we'll do this. The namaste. Alright, middle rope taunt. Mm-hmm. Seductive hip shake. Don't mind if I do. Alright. How about a muscle flex? There we go. Like a Young Bucks pose on the corner. How about this one? Oh yeah, we'll do that one too. You're looking really tough and strong, guys. What's the Dana's? We could do that. We could also do this. Absolutely, we're doing this. Yeah, okay. And we'll do that one too. No Callisto. No Callisto. Yeah, hip shaker. Yep. Here we go. Let's get a New Day thing. Apron to the ringside. What can we do? Big E? Yep. Absolutely we are. Take a bow. Yeah, we'll do take a bow. That's obnoxious, right? What else can we do? Let's do Dana Brooks. I think Dana Brooke has a whole lot of fun and really just character-defining moments in her taunts and what she says in the ring. I think it's really good that way. A little too sweet in the corner? I don't think so. Let's see... Let's go with Naomi's here. And we can also do... No, nothing in the for the crowd. We're not doing it for the crowd. You know what? We've been watching him do it for so long, but Randy Orton's just thing into the crowd where he just lifts his arms up and then just looks off into the heavens is so perfect. It's such a perfect thing to do. We're going to go ahead and do that. What's Neville? What does Neville do? Nah. That's too babyface. We're heels. We do heel things. Alright, arm spread. Let's do the too sweet. We'll do too sweet. Okay. Okay, opponent taunt. Haven't we... We're almost done. Let's see. What can we do? Wrestling superstar. Nope. Yeah, we'll do the air guitar strumming. What's the Carmella? Oh, absolutely we're doing Carmella. I thought that'd be the moonwalk. Can we do a moonwalk? Because if we can do a moonwalk, that would be just amazing. Yeah, we're going to do that. What else can we do? Let's see. This would be... that would be Santino Marella. One of them. I think he does that. Did he do that? I just remember the trombone thing and the snake thing. Oh, yeah. We'll do that one. Oh, please don't hurt me. Please don't hurt me. Another slap on the ass. There we go. Alright, this thing is taking a long time. If you're still with me, I appreciate you, and I love you. Alright, we'll do the clown thing there. Alright. Oh, that's a cool, shitty thing to do. Little crocodile tears, why not? What does Becky do here? You know what? We have big, long hair. That works. We can do that. Okay, so it looks like with all our moves here, we don't have a super kick party. We have a Hurricane Rana party, which is cool. We can do that, I guess. That's an obnoxious thing to do. Okay, and we will also do just a finger point. All right. Did we not do this? Let's just get a few of these things in place here. I always like Cesaro's little thing there. Aggressive finger pointing. Why not? Kisses. Oh yeah, kisses. That's the one we do. We do kisses. And we do kisses. Alright, now you hate me, right? Or maybe you love me. I think that works either way now. Let's just get all this together. Sheamus' thing is fine, I guess. Game over. Dana Brooke. Hip shaker. We'll do the hip shaker. Alright. Looking straight down at somebody and then gyrating your hips. That is super annoying. We will do that. Do take a bow again, and then we will do the big muscle flex. Okay, foot stomps Bray Wyatt. No, I like this. We'll do that. Come on already. That's very Raven. That's so Raven. All right, I like this. Reminds me of the Miz. I think the Miz is a great bad guy. Foot stomps, maybe. Bring it on? Yeah, we'll do bring it on. Alright. We're good. Wake up, taunt. Wake up, taunt. Yeah, I think all of this is fine. Let's just make sure nothing's embarrassing. Yeah, we're good there. We're good here. Foot stomps, let's change that to... What does Roman Reigns do? He waits, and he's like... Yeah, I kind of like this one. We'll go with this one. Okay. I think we're good. I think we're good. I think we finally finished. Let's accept, yeah? Okay, so while we're here, let's go ahead and work out our attributes. Okay, attributes dictate how strong your superstar is. Upgrade your attributes to raise your overall rating and become the most powerful superstar. Don't mind if I do. Now, we do a lot of leg power. And we have quite a bit of VC, so let's go ahead and bring that up there. Mic performance, let's go ahead and also improve that. That seems important. I like to do a lot of grapple offense, so let's go ahead and get that there. Let's just, right off the bat, add 10 to everything. Okay? Let's see what that does to the old rating. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We've done this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We'll go to 70 here. 70 here. Looks like it's 70 all across the board. And that's cool. We can do that, 70 all across the board. Now we're as strong as Tyler Breeze in this game. Who, from what I've read, is upset about his ranking. So is Rusev. I imagine a lot of people are upset about their ranking. That seems to be how it goes. I don't really have an issue with anybody's ranking as of yet. I do think... I don't have the NXT version. But what, Nakamura is an 86? I think that should be higher. I know we go by what happens in the WWE, and he hasn't made it to the main roster yet, though he is definitely deserving of such. But he has such a storied career in New Japan, headlined many shows for many years, had quite the rivalry with Tanahashi. I think he totally deserves to have high 80s, low 90s, maybe. I'd put him up there. But for the most part, everybody else... Okay, maybe Andre the Giant also needs a higher rating, but he was also limited physically. And I guess that's how they show that. Okay, so all this is going to 70, and that's already brought us up to 76. Which is pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed. Alright, so that's a good improvement. Reversal, bring that up to an 80. Mic performance. Okay. So now we got that. We're at 77. We know we want to throw a lot of super kicks. So we'll bring that up. Movement speed. I want to be fast. And I want my strike speeds to be fast. So let's bring that up to 80. Grapple speed's up to 80. Our strength should be a little stronger. Our agility, that should be an 80 as well. Stamina, that is super important, right? Stamina recovery. Where is the reversals? Like how many reversals we can get? Aha! This is probably the most important stat to have. Oh, we're at 168 already. Oh, boogers. Okay. Well, I guess we're good there. We'll just bank the rest. We're at 79. That's not bad. Okay. Abilities. I don't think we can buy anything right now. Yeah, we can't buy anything right now. We'll have to come back for it later. Okay, what about manager? What do we have here? See, we can only have female, all the women wrestlers here, and then Paul Heyman can be our managers. And I just don't think, like, that's right. I think there are certain managers on the roster, Lana, Paul Heyman, Dana Brooke at one time. Though she hasn't been used... Well, she's still used like that. Carmella, certainly, at one time. And I think that's it out of actual... Well, Natalya at one time, sure. But the rest of them are all wrestlers. And Eva Marie. Burn on Eva Marie. Alright, I think that's gonna do it. That was quite the long episode, I know. But very important to get our moves set. This next one... coming up, I'm going to try to get it out as fast as possible, is going to be focused on the entrance and the victory sequence. Very important. Maybe even the video. I don't know yet. But let's go ahead and call it quits there. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. For now, this is Will. I am signing off. Take care of yourself. And I will see you next time, baby.